The White House is expressing new doubts today over a nuclear deal between Iran, Turkey, and Brazil, or among them. Under the agreement, Iran would send much of its low-grade nuclear fuel to Turkey. And in return, Turkey would provide Iran with fuel rods to run a medical research reactor, which sounds like progress. Jim Walz is a research associate at the Massachusetts Institute of Technology, or MIT. He's met with Iran's president four times now. Sounds like progress, doesn't it, Jim?
If it had happened last October, it might have been progress, because that's when it was first proposed as part of a confidence-building measure. But it has taken a tortured route, and now is probably more than anything else an attempt to derail sanctions at the UN.
So what's an America to do?
Well, it puts the president in a tough position because we're friends with Brazil and Turkey. Turkey is a NATO ally. They're also on the Security Council right now. They're temporary members of the Security Council. And so they're saying, look, we have this deal, therefore we don't need any sanctions. And it's hard for the president to turn around and say, we're not going to take a deal that was pretty good, 6 months ago. The thing to remember about this, Shep, is it's a deal. It's not the deal. It was originally just a sort of side thing to get negotiations going, to have some momentum. But the core of the issue with Iran is not this medical reactor. It's the enrichment process. And today, Iran even said that it would continue enriching up to 20%, which was the reason what they were doing, because they said the deal wasn't going anywhere. So I think we're getting mixed signals here.
Jim Walz, it certainly sounds like it, and not everybody thought that these sanctions were going to be the end-all, be-all that they could have been because of a lack of participation, and so many people getting oil out of Iran and having a money deal. Jim Walz, we're out of time, but it's great to see you. Thanks so much.